idea of making this bill is really for a zombie movie without zombies. Yung movie, zombie movie siya na walang zombie.
Pwede mo ba explain, Derek?
Hindi, para siyang, di ba sa mga Walking Dead, sa mga horror, di ba? Lalakad yung tatlong tao, pinuputakti sila ng train to Busan, di ba? Nasa loob sila ng tren, ang daming zombie. This movie is about a group of PDEA agents trapped in a place and everyone is at war with each other. So, ganong klaseng adrenaline, ganong klaseng nervyos, ganong klaseng takot ang mangyayari for each one of them. For each one of them. And, of course, at the end of the film, ang ayaw naman namin mangyari, because we started this movie, hindi pa nagpapalit ng gobyerno. We started this movie, mag-e-election pa lang for the new government.
So you mean to say, Derek, Pinoy po po ang presidente?
Originally, yes.
Okay.
So, nung nagsushoot na kami ng movie, pumasok na yung bagong gobyerno, which is yung kay President Rodrigo Duterte. So, hindi naman, parang ang kalos naman namin na gagawa kami ng pelikula na hindi naman namin itatakal yung totoong drug war sa Pilipinas. So what we did was, we don't want to be prejudiced to the government. We don't want to gather Facebook rants. And alam mo yun, hindi yung parang ikukulit namin lahat ng reklamo, ito ilalagay sa pelikula. But what we did was, we took out all of that, in-erase namin sa utak namin, and start fresh. How would the PDEA drug war unfold if it happens now? So, more or less, with the help of PDEA, with the help of the research we had for drugs, etc., we put together something that sort of parang finds out what's wrong and what's right about this whole issue of the drugs. And it's not to go against the opposition, or it's not to go against the government, but it's really an objective view of what's wrong and what's right about it.
And lastly, na lang po bang bali lang, because everybody has been saying na sobrang hirap and talagang serious sila sa taping. Ano po yung pinaka-fun na moments na maaalala niyo on set? Kung sino man po yung may nakaalala,
ang pinaka-fun, sobrang hirap.
So, I guess the favorite part of the whole movie for me, yung kasama-sama kaming lahat sa tent. But we're not shooting yet. All the food, yung dinadala namin, all the chicken joy. I guess, anytime Alex or Tarek was on set, wala, game on. Ang pulit ka na eh. Game on.
Go to food trip, ano po yung mga ginagawa
niyo pambalit? Kwentuhan, gisme, yun lang. Training.
Okay. May iba po ba mga fun moment
dyan? Parang at one point, we were all, meron, diba sa yung tent namin, usually diba, formal sets, magkakahiwalay. Yes. Yung sa amin, I think it was three tents combined. So, lahat kami nandun. Tapos, yung for me, yung pinaka-fun moment is one time, nagdala si Anne ng sobrang ganda na chair. Tapos, at the end of the day, apat na sa cast na may parehong chair. Nag-shopping sila that day. Tapos, pare-pareho na kami yung may chair. Kasi for the longest time, si Brandon, wala siyang chair. Natutulog siya sa ilalim ng floor. Natutulog siya sa ilalim ng floor. Minsan, out of town, shoot kami. May mga impis na natutulog natin sa floor kasi wala pa ang chair na kasha kay Brandon. Until then, you were the one who brought the nice chair.
No, he found it.
No, you brought the nice chair, and then Anne Malabon. Yeah. Everyone got okay. Malay. Si Brandon yung nakahanap ng chair. Lahat ng cast, almost all the cast, started buying. So, may mga little moments na fun na gano'n. Maraming fun moments. Pero food trip talaga kami as a group all the time.
Thank you, Mara. You look great, by the way. Love
you. I just want to ask, since this movie is coming out in so many international film festivals, Frederick, Eric, when you started this film, were you thinking of really gunning for international release?
I think for most of the movies we make in reality entertainment, and of course this one is we partnered with Viva on this, Viva Entertainment. The kind of movies I really want to make are the ones that are local but has a strong potential to go international. International meaning not necessarily film festival, but international in terms of commercial release, being streamed online, being sold for DVD and Blu-ray and theatrical. And for Bypass, they've always been, after on the job, lagi nilang tinatanong, you need to do a full-on action film. And sabi ko, I don't have a story yet for that. And so I moved on to other movies, you know. Pero for this one, when we found the story and we put it together, I thought maybe now is the time to do this. And happy din kami that the international community of film lovers is sort of embracing it, and may gusto sila, gusto nila ipalabas in their festivals. This coming July 15, we're showing it in New York. July 18 will be in Korea, and then July 19. And then Montreal. Yeah.
My question next is for Brandon. Since I want to know how you got involved with the project, maybe for Brandon and Derek Eric, because Brandon is not based here. So how did that happen? Because everybody else from the cast is based here, but how did you cast Brandon and how did you discover the project?
Ate, sino nagsabi na hindi ako based here? Ano nagsabi nun? Sinusin ako ah, dulisipisin na, dalawang passport ko, dito na ako, may negosyo na, may bahay na, dito na ako, dalawang ng kotse ko, dito na ako. So you know, everybody thinks that parang I'm flying in and out back and forth. I do travel a lot, I work with one championship, I'm still the champ there, and I still have a lot of obligations with them. So I'm always traveling, but dito na ako, we're all here. I moved here maybe 2 years ago. We started training with the PTK Tirsha guys, and the way that this happened was dumaban ako dito sa Pilipinas, nanalo ako, I was the champ, had the belt, I was in the hotel, and we had some meetings set up for management groups and some different people that wanted to talk about maybe moving here and starting a career here in entertainment after fighting. So I don't know how it happened. I was at the hotel, and then I don't know if I got a phone call or somebody came to my room. We're all hanging out. I just want the belts on the table, and I'm supposed to hang out in the Philippines for another week. We're gonna party and enjoy the win. And somebody said, "Hey, you should really talk to Donda Monteverde, Derek Eric." And I was like, "Okay, senior, how do I call them? Let's talk." And then somebody sent me your phone number, your guys' phone number, and nandito ako si Derek Eric and si Donda nasa States pala. They were in Canada and in Las Vegas for film festivals, filming stuff. Natawa ko si silang dalawa and said, "Are you guys serious about meeting? Are you serious about managing? Are you serious about entertainment career? Dito sa Pilipinas?" Sabi na yes. Right then and there, I said, "Okay, kung kaya nyo, leave Las Vegas, I'll fly straight into LA. Mag-meet na lang tayo sa LA, I get off of the plane on this time." Sabi nila, oo, they drove straight from Vegas, met me in LA. We talked about yung plano ko, anong pangarap ko dito sa Pilipinas? Anong daanan gusto kong, I guess, which path I wanted to take. We signed that night. The first thing I asked though, when I asked them, Derek, Eric, and Sidonda, di ba bago pa ako? Can I do an easy movie? That's you know, kind of funny, corny, so I can get used to being in front of the camera. Okay, okay, meron pa harap sa Brandon. Okay, meron na. Pagdating mo, meron na script. Okay, game. Oh yeah, by the way, Ann Curtis is the lead. Huh? That's not a corny movie. That has to be a serious movie. Di kaya. I found a
Like what you mentioned earlier, that there are no female leads in action movies. How important is it for you to have this really strong female representation in an action movie?
I think it's about time. I think it's been way too long since we've had a female lead in an action film, when there are so many capable actresses out there who can do the job, diba? But it just takes one director who has a script, who has that kind of faith na parang kahit din at isang babae going on some action film at siyang lead. So I think it's just an amazing movement for us in our industry, as it was mentioned earlier, kasi it's already such a huge trend in Hollywood. All of these spy movies, Atomic Blonde, Red Sparrow, Resident Evil, Tomb Raider came out again. It's all female leads. So bakit hindi pa natin umpisahan dito sa Philippines, diba? So that's why I guess why I'm also passionate about this project, because it's a stepping stone not only for me but for other actresses in our industry. Thank you.
My favorite director, Eric Bardi.
Hanggang pala favorite ko pala si Director Eric.
I miss you, Derek.
Hi, John. Love you.
Love you.
Mwah, mwah, chum-chum. Chum-chum.
Derek, any regrets nung hindi po napa-screen sa Cannes Film Festival? What really happened?
Oh, may... We wanted to go through it, but our... There are contractual issues that we're dealing with.
Okay.
Between pinag-usapan namin ng Viva and ng reality, which we cannot announce yet. You'll hear about it siguro around October of this year. So yon, we nag-decide kami na hindi na, and then Wellgo wanted to go big in the US and in Canada. And of course, we're fixing the Middle East na screening. So parang okay na rin kami na gano'n.
Ayaw mo na sa local festivals, Greg?
Ha?
Ayaw mo na sa local festivals?
Eh, hindi naman nila kami kinuha nung last year. Hindi naman kami, hindi kami pinili.
Eh, di ba?
Kaya nga, proud na proud ako ngayon na gusto ko tayo palabas sa August.
Oo, diba?
Oo,
napaso ka na? Eh, oy. Parang nagbali ka na naman yata yung ano, pinaglaban mo dati ah.
Napapahiya ako
eh. Eh, magay mo, diba? Blessing naman mo yan. So, gano'ng malaki, gano'ng kagastos, alam na namin yung scope direct eh. Gano'ng kagastos itong pelikula ngayon?
Ay,
if you would mind.
Yeah, it's quite expensive, and not a lot of them know about it. I don't know, nasan si Vincent? I don't know if I can divulge.
Okay,
but, bait-bait nga ng Viva sa akin eh, kasi we started with hindi naman ganong budget. But of course, gusto namin maganda. Lagi kaming meeting, over ka na, over na yung movie ah. We ended up with dollars, we ended up with around 1.6. Dollars, 1.6 million dollars.
Oh, sige, compute na kayo.
So,
spoiled ka nga ah.
That's why kailangan mamaya pag-uwi niyo magsulat na kayo ng maganda at nang mabawi namin ito.
Yes,
it's expensive. We built, imagine this, experiment out ko lang kung kunyari producer ko kayo, kukwento ko kung bakit naging ganun yung budget. So we built an entire set on hindi naman 5 hectares. Joros Carrera si AJ. It's an 8,000 square meter set. We built the set there. Every day we have rain. So naisip na namin na mag-set up ng pool dun sa location so that we always fill it up with water because lagi naman may ulan. We always have a crowd of people in every scene. They're not just normal crowds na crowd people and passersby. Most of them are eventually gonna be stuntmen because they'll also be the ones running around, jumping. So imagine a crowd scene, hindi siya crowd scene na parang palengke, okay, lakad kayo dyan, pisil-pisil kayo isda. Hindi siya ganun. They have things that they need to do in the scene. Papaligtad sila, masusuntok sila. We have constant, wantusawa yung parel sa bala. Okay. And imagine one piece of bullet is 50 pesos. In the opening of the film, parang gusto ko na ikwento. In the opening of the film, may isang shootout na lahat sila involved. Ang mauubos mo siguro ng bala, may 8,000 rounds. Alam mo yun ng bala. Kasi tuloy-tuloy lang yan, take. And that's just one scene. We have other scenes. We have explosions. Non-stop yung mga squibs and putukan. The camera requirements and the lighting are medyo matugo. We are constantly on two cameras, but several days, we have four cameras on the set. Ito pa yung isang medyo madugo. So, apat na yung camera namin sa eksena, apat na cameraman din yun. Lahat sila sabay-sabay. I mean, that's how bloody the shoot is.
How contented were you dun sa result? Napanood mo na ba ng pelikula?
Hindi. Natuwa ako kasi, I mean, working with Viva Entertainment and reality, I get to do what I wanna do. Diba? Wala akong parang masakali, wala akong
restrictions.
I send them the edited footages, and yun na yun, usap-usap. Ganun lang. I'm lucky to have gotten actors who have given me so much trust. So much trust to the point na parang hindi na sila nagtatanong, di ba? Kasi I was rewriting the film as we were shooting eh. So parang basta ganito yun, kasi mamaya sa may tulog, ganito ka eh. Talaga direk, oh, ganito, galit ka dito. Mamaya kasi magpapati kayo eh. Alam mo yun? So, medyo masaya din. And hindi sila yung parang robot naman. Mm-hmm. Diba? They take care of how they look. They take care of what they need to do on a particular scene. Maraming mga sakit-sakit sila nakukuha, pero wala kaming away sa set. Never.
Wala nag-design direct.
Wala rin diva.
Oh, wala.
Wala rin diva. And you know how legitimate this film is? Arpitea Consultants, we were doing this film in the midst of the drug war. And yes. at the end of the film, you're gonna see a memoriam. Kasi Marawi also happened. Several of the Marawi guys who were sent there is part of the film. You're gonna see them. They eventually ended up going to Marawi. Pero we shot them bago sila lumipat papunta Marawi. So eventually, we saw them. Nung bumalik kami, kasi may naiwan kami yung eksena, bumalik kami doon later na. Some of them putol na we have a list of people that we are giving a tribute to, parang memoria, in memoriam, sa end ng film. Our main video consultant has been guiding us from the start of the film to the end. Right after na-finish yung film, got shot outside of his house. And on a wedding anniversary nila ng asawa niya. So we were in the midst of that. Yun. So I mean, in as much as it's a really good popcorn entertaining movie, there's also a lot of kind of weight to how it was made.
Good luck, Derek. Tanong ko lang si Anne. Anne, anong ang gusto mong improve sa pelikula ng iba? Kadahilan-hirap ka?
Again, I think it's exactly that. Kaya ko. Kaya namin. May mga babae. Kaya namin. I think that's what I would like to prove in this film. And yet again, you know, maybe this is the time now that more directors will fight for a script like this. Hindi naikwento ni Direk, pero nakailang movie houses siyang nilapitan or mother studios na nilapitan. But everybody kept on saying maybe it would be better if it was a male.
So magaling ka na sa bukbukan, ha?
Kaya. Kayang-kaya. In fact, gagawin niyo lang tagline niyo.
We had an MTRCB screening the other day.
Okay,
and then after the screening, Milaw, sabi ng MTRCB na mahirap pala ang lugar ni Erwan. Mahirap pala ang posisyon ni Erwan. Alam ba niya to nung pakasal siya?
Biyasana, hindi na fragile na si Anne Curtis. So, pwede ka na mabuntis, Anne, after this.
If it's God's will, why not?
Congratulations and good luck.
Thank you.
For ByBus, we support the Hansha not just internationally but locally as well. So thank you for everyone for supporting the movie. Sana po mapanood nyo August 1 onwards. Share it sa social media, Instagram, Facebook, and Derek, Eric, and the whole, not just the whole cast but the whole crew. They all did such an amazing job. Sana po supportahan po natin yung sariling atin.
Po, maraming salamat po sa mga pumunta at ayun, supportahan niyo po ang ByBus. Ayun, tulungan niyo po kami isulat itong napakagandang pelikulang ito. At syempre, uulitin lang namin itong pelikulang ito, sets the standards for action at pinapakita po rito na kaya po ng mga kababaihan gumawa rin ng action. Ayan, maraming salamat.
Ayun po, lagi po nilang sinasabi kakaibang movie, pero ito po ang totoong kakaibang movie. But, at ito po yung, yun nga pinaghirapan ng buong cast, ng direct team, everyone, and Brandon and everyone else. At sana po abangan nyo, this is one of the movies I'm really excited to see as well. And on the big screen, and there you have it. August 1 po, ByBus. Sana po supportahan nyo.
Well, again, I just want to invite everyone August 1 to check out this film. If you want to see a film with a kick butt female lead, it's going to kick everyone's butt in this film, you go watch this film. If you want to see a film with a squad that has bonds, that they're going to fight for each other till the end, you come see this film. And I'm so thankful to be part of this film, one, because it gave me a chance to meet all of these wonderful people and to be here right now, two, it gave me enough money to, sorry, shameless plug, able to start off Manila Wrestling Federation, so check that out as well. But if you want to see non-stop action, this is probably, I mean, we saw this all, and we saw the film, and we just like, what? Oh, it was amazing. So please support Daniel. Ngayon ko lang po na gets na pag sinasabi ng mga tao na pinaghirapan po namin tong film na to. Yes, yes. We really, really put all of our hearts and souls into this film, and I hope each and every one of you magsulat na po ngayon. Right now, ngayon po. Please, thank you.
Sa maganda pong pelikula to, sa sobrang ganda po, pati po ako nagandaan eh. Pelikula ko na yun, tapos nagandaan ako. Kaya magaganda kayo dito, promise. Isa po akong komedyante, pero pagdating dito, medyo dito ko naramdaman na parang naging actor talaga ako. Yun, umuwi po ko talaga ako dito ng Duguan. Duguan, tapos diligtas po ng dugo na yun yung pagkahuli sa F. Kasi umuwi kami alas 6 eh, tapos... Oh, may stunt po ako dito, alas 3 sa madaling araw. Doon po ako na aksidente sa Siko. Pinatalon po ako ni Direk Eric sa bubong. Kumidyante, pinatalon. Hello. Yan po. Maraming po salamat. Panoorin niyo po ByBus August 1. Salamat po.
This is more for the people on the stage. Salamat ng inyo, you guys, not for the crowd. Ayan, as soon as you see the movie, you guys are gonna fall in love with it. Everybody already said everything. For everyone here on stage, maraming salamat sa inyong lahat. Thank you for welcoming me. Thank you for making my first film so easy. Thank you for giving me and helping me every time that I needed it. Ang galing niyo talaga, and thank you guys. You are now my family. If you need me, I'm there.
We love you, Don Don.
Guys, ang galing na magtagalog ni Bravo.
Yes. Siyempre bago si Direk Eric, I'd like to invite all of you to please help and support us, spread the word about Bybust. Showing na po siya on August 1. We're all very, very excited na mapanood ng lahat ng ito. I think ang pinaka-importante dito ay sana talaga panuuri nilang lahat pag lumabas na to sa sinehan. It just goes to show na even ladies can be badass too. Kaya sana supportahan niyo yung pelikulang to. Everyone that's here worked really hard for it. Napakaganda po ng kwento. Napakaganda po ng action. Actually, ito na yun eh. Nagbabalik action na ang mga pelikulang Pilipino. Kaya sana po supportahan natin ito.
Okay, in addition to Anne, hindi na ako mag-invite. We have an announcement. I cleared it with those two guys there, standing in the corner. The movie will be showing on August 1 in Philippine showing nationwide. Rating is R16. So we need all the help from you guys to push it sa mga manonood natin. Maraming salamat.
And on that note,